The second topic is about the universe. We are living on the earth, and when we see the sky on the horizon, we see sky on the top of us, and you can see on the side of us. You go to the, or like see, you can see the sky is here, a sky is here, a sky is at the back of you, sky is in the front of you, on the right side of you, and a sky is also below us, because the earth is spherical. So people living on the here, people are living here, and for them, they can see the sky also above them. So the earth is spherical, and the sky which we see, that the scientists call it universe. And that sky is also spherical, below. The Lupanathin is below, the spherical. So this sky is also spherical. It's also circle. It's also below. And the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ told us, and the Quran said, that Allah said about the sama, بِأَيَّدْنَا and then وَإِنَّا لَمُوسِعُونَ, that we created the sky, this universe with might, وَإِنَّا لَمُوسِعُونَ, and we are expanding it. So this is like a balloon, our universe, our sky is like a balloon, and it's keep on expanding. And it has a size, it's a very big, huge creation of Allah. What is the size of the universe? Or this sky which we can see everywhere? If you go in the diameter is like this, in the middle of the circle, it's 93 billion light years. You need to travel from one point to the one another point for 93 billion years. But it's not the speed of the car or motorcycle or the airplane or even the jet, which is 2,000 kilometers per hour. But the speed of the light from the one is one point of the universe, one point of the sky, until the last point on the other side, 93 billion years. And the speed of the light, 300,000 kilometers per second. 300,000 kilometers per second multiplied by 60 seconds, so it becomes 1 minute travel. Multiplied by 60, so it becomes 1 hour travel. Multiplied by 24 hours, so it becomes 1 day travel. And multiplied by 365 solar year, one light year. Multiplied by 93 billion. You cannot imagine how big is the distance from one part of the sky or the universe until the other part of the universe. That's called diameter. But the circumference, if you make all round of the universe, this way all the end of the universe, circumference, that is 146 billion light years. 146 billion light years. So that's first sky. And the Prophet Muhammad said, the above the first sky, there is another sky. And he said there is a distance between these two. And he said on the second and third sky, there is distance, a huge distance. And he keep on saying there are seven skies. And above the seven sky, there is still the space. And above the seven sky, there is space. And there is the earth, which is also spherical. So seven sky are spherical. And the arsh, the greatest creation of Allah, through which Allah controls the arsh, the universe, the all the creation, is also spherical because it's above the sky. So a sky is below, a sky is on the right, a sky is on the left, a sky is everywhere. So above the sky, the another sky until the seven skies, and above the seven sky there is also a space, and then above this space there is the arsh, the throne, and after that no more space. When you go outside, there is space. Who make this space? Allah make this space. Do Allah need this space? No, Allah doesn't need this space. Who make the time? Allah make the time. But Allah doesn't need the time. So until the arsh, there is a space and time. Above the arsh, no space, no time, no creation. End of the world. End of the universe. End of the creation is arsh, the throne. And this throne is, Allah is controlling the creation through that throne. If some nonsense is speaking that Allah sits on the throne, that is shirk. You make Allah like a human being. Allah doesn't need to sit. He is infinite. He is unlimited. All the creation in front of Allah is smaller than atom only. So Allah is controlling the universe with the throne, with the arsh. And arsh is a Lauhe Mahfuz, the hard disk, which has all the programming of the universe. And Allah controls it. So very, very important thinking I was thinking yesterday, that we have a space in the sky. So I was thinking, when space is finishing? Hangang sanyung space. Then I get the answer, the space is until only Arsh. After Arsh, there is no space. And after Arsh, there is no time. So Allah is free from the forms. He is not linear, or He is not circle, He is not a square, He is not triangle, He is not solid, liquid or gas. He is unique. He is the most powerful. But the creation, the earth is spherical, the skies are spherical, the Arsh is spherical. And the space and the time is between this creation only. Why we have a time? Because of the sun and moon. The sun and moon, if there is no sun and moon, we have no time. Why we have a space? Because from the earth until the sky, that's called space. The earth until the sky, that's space. Like example, we have a territory, like Philippine or any other country, they have a territory. The territory is not only the land, it's a sea also. And it's also the space. Like example, when there is two countries fighting, they control the airspace. So space is also dominion. It's also the kingdom which Allah created. And space has a limit. Because before, the scientists thought that the space is unlimited or the universe is unlimited. But it's not true. Because only unlimited is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is infinite and unlimited. But the space has a limitation. And the limit of the space is until the Arsh. Beyond the Arsh, no creation, no space, and no time. The time ends until the Arsh. And after that, there is no time, and there is no creation, and there is no space. So that was the second part of the topic, and inshallah, now we can have a question answer, and we can have a dua, then everyone can eat also. So if any question, you can ask, inshallah. Meron too big? The liman rele? Too big meron? Okay, any question here? Okay. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, this is the addiction now. All the world now holding cell phone, 24-hour cell phone. Cell phone has become a curse now. It's very, very big problem now. Everybody holding cell phone. Cell phone become parang addiction now. So it's really need to check this. There should be timing. No unlimited time. You need to hold the cell phone only for a time. And after that, no more. So it's a big problem for the whole world today. The cell phone is a big problem. Before, cell phone only used for the calls. When this call come, how are you? Assalamu alaikum. Finish. But now no call. So many things. Games there, videos there, movies there, everything is there. And people are busy. Everything, 24 hours. When person walk up, what is first thing the person do? Kung gising tao, anong hanap niya? When the person wake up, ano hanap niya? Cell phone. This problem now. So cell phone is become destroying our lives. You need to avoid the cell phone. Try to make the time, okay, this time to this time cell phone. After that, no more. My father, when he was alive, when he come home, he shut the phone off. No more. He will not use cell phone. Until morning, no more. When he go to the work again morning, he will start open, off, on, then he go to the work. After that, no, he use it. When he come home, off, no more. So that should be the time limit for the cell phone. Cell phone is blessing, but it become destruction for us. So many problem with the cell phones. And it has also lots of radiation, which people are getting, destroying their brain also. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, that's also problem. There are people who died with the face mask. When jogging or running with face mask, they die because they are getting back the problem with the breathing also. And your breath is not changing also. So try to have some mask with some breath. Better with some, you know, holes. So people can have fresh air all the time and changing the air. And then not everywhere you need to wear mask. When you are in inside some places, try to get the fresh air with removing the mask also. Yes. Mobile? Okay, games are, you cannot say the haram, but this destroying, because addiction. How many hours children playing? 24 hours sometimes. 12 hours, 13 hours, 14 hours, 15 hours, no stop. In the pagod, if you play football, maybe 3 hours, 4 hours, you are tired. Games, no tired. Even 12 hours, walang pagod. Football, 4 hours, 3 hours, you are pagod na. But cell phone, even 24 hours, hindi na pagod. Playing and playing, and then it's destroying the character. For example, a young child is playing the killing game. Killing. Okay. He starts from the morning until night time. He is killing people 24 hours. Shoot. How many, you ask him, how many you kill today? Maybe 1 million, subhanAllah. What happened to the character of the child if he kill 1 million people in the one game, one night, until one whole day? 1 million, he patay. Killing, subhanAllah. What happened to the character now? What is his character now? Nothing. He only practiced to kill people only. Nothing else. The game is always killing. With blood, with bad words. So what is it? Halal? Not halal, this one. It's destruction. Subhanallah, if the child, he don't know how to respect the elders, how to speak the good words, how to, he doesn't want to pray also. He doesn't want to eat also. Nothing. He just kill people. Kill. What is his character now? Good character, bad character? Very bad character. Because every day, morning until night, killing. Night time also killing. No sleeping. Sleeping in the morning. When wake up again, he start killing people. Subhanallah. It's more than, you know, because it's destroying the character. There are some good games. Maybe you have some building games or some quiz game or some good character game. But mostly the games are destructive. I don't see it haram. But some games are really haram because it's full of destruction. They just non-stop killing, non-stop destruction there. So it's really, really big problem. And what is the use of this? And the children getting irritated. Okay, level 1, level 2, level 3, level... He played for 4 hours, level 17. And then talo, then go back to level 1. He's very angry. And his character getting always angry. Because he tried to go to 17 level and he want to go 18 and 19 and 20. But 17 he dropped. Now he go back to level 1. So he get irritated now. Sometimes he started to the bad words also. He's speaking bad words and shouting also. So it's very important that the game should be productive and there should be limit. For me, it's not bad, good more than 1 hour. 1 hour is enough. 1 hour game, but good games, not the bad games. That productive games and not the destructive games, because there are lots of destructive games. For example, the keep on shooting and with the blood, subhanAllah, some even games they are cutting the head. What happened to the child when he started to cut the heads in the game? He's cutting the heads every day. How many cut heads? Maybe 1,000, 10,000, 20,000. Subhanallah. How many people you kill? 100,000, 200,000, 1 million people I kill. So what happened now? This is not good anymore because it's destroying the character. That's why the children now, because they are addiction with the games, they don't respect the parents. They don't respect elders. They don't respect anyone because their life, their character is destroying. There was a, my friend, he said his child playing 24 hours game and he become very violent. He become very, very violent. He said that he go in the outside the house. And if he get chicken, he cut the chicken, the neck of the chicken, he make putul. Subhanallah. Because already, you know, playing games and he's become like crazy. So every time he go outside, he get chicken, he hold the chicken neck and he do like this. Because he doing the game every day. So it's a big problem. The game should be with limitation. Without limit is very, very dangerous. So anything else? Yes. As-salam. Okay, the poor people, organic food is very, because before this people, the modernism, they tell us, give us a fake products. Now they want to give us organic products, very expensive. So the poor people, why they are living in the city? Why they don't go to the province and produce their own vegetables? Pure vegetables, organic vegetables. It's good for them. Because if you go, if the poor people, they have a hard life and they have all the pollution and all the chemicals and pesticide foods and these all foods. The good thing for the poor people, go to the province, do the farming, do the fishing, do the agriculture and fresh and organic without pesticide and without fertilizers. The same time, the poor and their family, they can eat the organic foods and they can also sell those organic foods. So suggestion that if they cannot afford the organic foods, it's better to transfer to province. No need to rent the house anymore. You have your own house in the province. And try to have a good and beautiful life in the province. So that's my solution for the people, the poor people who cannot afford to have organic foods. Yeah, anything else? Yes.
Yeah,
there is lots of water under because this water is created by Allah, and lots of water also absorbing. Because the water cycle is created by Allah, that the seas are evaporated, so water goes in the vapors, goes in the clouds, and Allah bring the clouds anywhere to rainfall. But the other way of water is absorbing in the earth. So whenever the excess water on the earth, it will absorb. And it becomes a rivers inside the earth. So there are lots of water inside the earth. So deep well is a very good solution to get the clean water. Because outside water sometimes, it's very polluted because of the pollution in the sky, in the atmosphere. But when the water goes in the earth and absorbs in the earth, it becomes recycled, it becomes refined. It becomes like mineral water. So you get the deep well water, it's a very good source of fresh, clean water compared to the Mainilad water or the Navasa water. The best water for us is the deep well. It's a good suggestion. We try to make the deep well and get the clean water, because deep well water, if you get very deep, it's really very good water, no pollution there, because it's a system made by Allah. It's a filter system. Because of the earth crust, the water is getting filtered, and you can get the deep well water, which is very, very healthy, and you don't need to pay any more the Mainilad, which is very costly. So you can get the deep well water, one time deep well. Example, the poor people, they cannot afford to have a deep well. But the poor people in the squatter area, 100 families, they gather the money and make one deep well and make the lines connection for everybody. So you will not need any more Mainilad water, which is really polluted water. It's not very clean water because it's coming from the open rivers, which is always pollution from the factories and pollution from the sewerage, canal, etc. So many problems in the open water nowadays in the modern life, modernism or modern way of life. So what is good? Make a deep well, like 500 feet, and get the water and use it. It's very good water, clean water, because more you go deep, more clean water you get. But the communities who are poor, they can gather the money, like 50 families, 100 families, make one deep well. It's like mineral water you're getting from the earth. Okay? No, that's all? Yes.
Yeah. I heard when you said that recently there's the Voyager 2, went out outside of the solar system, and they detect high density and out of the spaces. So it's getting heavier and heavier when they going out from the space, this satellite. Scientists
can't
describe this very high density outside of the
spaces. Yeah. No, the scientists, first of all, you have to correct yourself. The scientists called it the spaces outside the gravity, correct? But it's not correct definition. When you go outside the masjid, even here right now in the masjid, there's also a space. Okay? The definition of a space is the space between the two bodies, the earth and the sky. So this all is space. So actually space is starting from the earth. When you above the earth, it's already space. Okay, we are in the space now. Okay, example, brother want to sit there and he will say, please give me the space. Okay, so space is a common word which can define all space. But the scientists call it space is outside the gravity. When you go outside the gravity, they call it space. But it's not true definition. Space is everything is space. Okay. Example, how many space here in this masjid is like 200 square meter. And if you want to get a cubic meter, So it's 219 square meter up above the height. It will be like 1,000 cubic meter. Okay. So this has a space. The space is could be square meter or cubic meter or cubic inch or cubic feet, whatever you can call it. Now the when you go outside the in the space, in the upper space, outside the gravity, it's heavy. You said heavy?
Yeah, it's getting heavy. The density is getting heavier when the
satellite is going down from the solar system. Yeah. But of course, what I understand, when you go outside in the outer space, everybody becoming their own orbit because of the gravity, because of the force which comes from the throne, from the earth. So there is an electromagnetic field in the space, and you are bound to have a, according to your body weight, according to your mass, you will have a orbit, and you have to move in your orbit. Like everything is moving in the orbit, the earth, the sky, the galaxies, or the sun and the moon and the planets and the stars. Once they are any, like example, then when the USA or China or Japan or any country, they shoot this rocket and they bring the satellite in the space. What happened to the satellite? The satellite will make the orbit right away. And they will rotate in the orbit. So when you're going out of the orbit, you have to make a force. That's why it's become dense and very hard to move, because you are going outside the orbit. So Allah makes the system in the space. Whenever you go outside the space, you will have an orbit and you will revolve in the orbit. So once you have to force yourself to go out of the orbit, so you become very hard to travel. So that could be the explanation for this. Okay? So inshallah, that's all. May Allah guide us. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار آمين. سبحان الله الحمد سبحان الله العظيم عدد خلق إذا نفسه زينة عرش ذات كلماته سبحان الله الحمد سبحان الله العظيم عدد خلق إذا نفسه زينة عرش ذات كلماته سبحان الله الحمد سبحان الله العظيم عدد خلق إذا نفسه زينة عرش ذات كلماته الله الرحمن الرحيم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام يا رحمن الرحيم يا أبر الآخر زار بعد رزاق أول ستار وفر الرحمن الرحيم يا ذا الجلال والإكرام يا رحمن الرحيم يا يحيي ويميت ويحيي ويميت يا في دار ومعز ومذل يا ذا الجلال والإكرام يا رحمن الرحيم لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين يا حي يا قيوم رحمتك نستغيث آمين يا حي يا قيوم رحمتك نستغيث آمين يا حي يا قيوم رحمتك نستغيث آمين والله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة هو الرحمن الرحيم الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم نعوذ برب الفلق من شر ما خلق ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب من شر النفاثات في العقد ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد نعوذ برب الناس ولك الناس إلى الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار آمين ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين آمين ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب آمين اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا واهدنا وعافنا وافزنا وانصرنا وارحمنا امين Ya Allah, our Lord, give us good in this world and good in the hereafter. Save us from anger and save us from hellfire. Ameen. Ya Allah, be happy with us and enter us in Jannah if it was in paradise in next life forever. Ameen. Ya Allah, guide us. Ameen. Ya Allah, forgive us. Ameen. Ya Allah, mercy on us. Ameen. Ya Allah, protect 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 our children and give long life. Ameen. Ya Allah, protect our children and give long life. Ameen. Ya Allah, protect our children and give long life. Ameen. Ya Allah, protect our children and all the children of the world and give long life. Ameen. Ya Allah, save us from all problems. Ameen. Ya Allah, save us from all sickness. Ameen. Ya Allah, we ask from you all good with your prophets and all good people. They ask from you. Ameen. Ya Allah, we seek your protection from all the evil from which your prophets and all good people. They seek your protection. Ameen. Ya Allah, accept all our dua. Ask in chinnat. Ask. Ameen. Thank you. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.